sacrifice another human being for what they've done to me. And
time, I'd like to introduce to you the current president of the Smith County Historical Society, who is completing his second year as president. John Trube, if you will, make your way up here to the front, and we're anxious to hear from him. Let's welcome John Trube.
Thank you very much, and on behalf of the Historical Society, we're very pleased and very proud, very honored to have all of you here in Tyler and Smith County to celebrate this reunion, and hope that you'll come back for the next couple of years anyway to reunion again. It can only get better and bigger in the next couple of years. I think we can see by this turnout the potential of it. The Historical Society has as its goal the protection and defense and the restoration and remembrance of things that are very precious and have great meaning to people of Smith County and what happened here. And certainly Camp Fannin was one of those things. You only need to look around and see the contributions that have been made by you people who were stationed here, and certainly those who stayed and contributed directly to Tyler, but all of you who stayed here for any period of time had a part in what Tyler has got in Smith County. And to that, we're very thankful to all of you, and we're very glad that you're here. Incidentally, I've heard all my life about people trading war stories, but boy, this is something to listen to all of y'all. I now know what they're talking about when they say war stories. Thank you very much, and I hope you have a good time tonight. Mr. Fowler and his band are going to entertain you quite well, as you'll see, and maybe bring back a few memories from some period of time ago for you. And they all want to thank you for putting all this together, and Mr. Anderson and Mr. St. Pierre and any number of you. It's a great thing. Really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
As John was saying, we would certainly be remiss if we didn't take just a moment to acknowledge all of the committee folks that have done so many different things in so many different areas to make this reunion possible. And I'd like to introduce them to you by committees, and we'd ask you to hold your applause until everyone from each committee has been introduced. As you came in Friday, you were greeted by the folks on the registration committee. Let me ask each one of you to stand as you're introduced and remain standing until the entire group has been introduced. On the registration committee, Mr. and Mrs. Lloyd Gilbert, Mr. and Mrs. Leroy Anderson, Mr. and Mrs. Julius Buchanan, Mr. and Mrs. Bob Lee, Mr. and Mrs. Tommy Lothar, Mr. and Mrs. Jack Pollard, Mr. Pratt Junkin, Mrs. Alsemeyer, who's a new member of the society, Mrs. Jerry Payne, and Mrs. Mildred Glover. Let's give all of these folks a hand. The the Decorations Committee, as you can tell by looking around, you put in a lot of time and effort, and we'd like to ask each one of them to stand and remain standing until the entire group's been introduced. Serving on the Decorations Committee, the General Chairman for Decorations, Mrs. Jack Greer, Mrs. George Foltz, and for those of you that are wives of the soldiers, let me tell you that Mrs. Foltz was in charge of the housing for the wives of the soldiers during the Camp Fannin days, and a lot of you may remember her. Also on the Decorations Committee, Mr. Sam Kidd, Mrs. Lloyd Gilbert, Mrs. Leslie Kirch, and Mr. and Mrs. Tom Lothar. We appreciate each of you. Serving on the Entertainment and Hospitality Committees are Mr. Bob Lee, Mr. Leon St. Pierre, Mr. Leroy Anderson, Mr. Robert Munt, Mrs. Leroy Anderson, Mr. Joe Theodore, and Mrs. Lloyd Gilbert. Would all of you all please stand? And last but not least, the three folks that I've had the pleasure of working with the most closely, the overall planning committee consisting of Mr. Jack Pollard, Mr. Leon St. Pierre, Mr. Leroy Anderson, and myself. Those folks have really put in the most work. Would each of you all say? At this time, I'd like to introduce to you Mr. Henry M. Bell III, the Vice President and General Manager of the Tyler Area Chamber of Commerce, to say a word of welcome.
Thanks, Dale. We're delighted to have you folks in town that haven't been here for 50 years. I hope you come back again. There's lots more to do, I hope, than there was 50 years ago. We would like to have you come back at any time. We hope you've had a good time this weekend, and if we can do anything to make your stay more hospitable, please let us know.
Before we turn the program over to Mr. Eddie Fowler and the Tyler Big Band Sound, I just have to tell you folks, judging from the way that you all came in here Friday afternoon from traveling and the way you look tonight, you clean up real good. And now let me turn the program over to Eddie Fowler and his bass. They'll begin the musical program here at 8 o'clock.
Thank you. you just don't like apple pie and butter's home cooking. This is Glenn Miller's Moonlight Serenade.
Thank you.
called Sentimental Journey.
Thank you.
divorce, anything you happen to have, we'd be glad to try to accommodate you. I think you'll love this one. This is a good old standard everybody loves. It's called the Anniversary Waltz. We pulled some good oldies, didn't we?
Thank you. Thank you.
trumpet on the lead trumpet is Dr. Bob Rossler. I tried to get him to give up his practice and just play with us. He won't do it. Dr. Bob Rossler on the lead.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so glad you're enjoying yourself and you keep having a good time. I am the catering director. I'm not just some person that walked in. So have a good time and thank you, Camp Fannin. And thank you so much for being there for us. We needed you and we really did need you. And God bless our troops forever. Thank you so much.
The next thing we have for you is a real treat. Some of you might remember this young lady. She performed at Camp Fannin during World War II, and her child has been her home. And she went out to entertain the troops periodically. And some of you close around this area know her. She has been singing in this area for a long, long time, at least 2 years, more than that. Peggy's been around a long time. Everybody knows Peggy. Would you give a real warm hand to Peggy Honeycutt? Remember this is an oldie back in World War II. If I didn't care. Remember that one? Thank you, Mother.
Thank you.
that particular number, we have three albums out that we went in the studios and made. We have three albums. So this particular number is on one of the albums. Now, the way we sell albums, there are tapes you put in your car and play. The first one, if you just buy one, it's 10. If you buy two, it's 15. If you buy three, it's 20 for all three. So we'd be glad to let you have some of them. We need the money anyway. I mean, we really don't, but if you'd like to have one or two or three of our tapes, we'd be glad to have them for you. This fellow on the back row back here, he's a retired postman. Can I tell him about who you are? Oh my goodness. He's kin to Swagger. You said I could tell him his name is Eddie Gilly. He's also kin to Mickey Gilly. And what's the other one? Gary Lee Lewis is kin to. We have a problem with that dangling in the back. We don't know what he's going to pray us to preach. But he'll be glad to sell you one of the tapes. He has the tapes back here. So when we take a little admission, if you like one, it's $10. Two, it's 15. Three, it's 20. So see what a bargain you get? They're good tapes. I think you'll enjoy them. Oh, we're going to do a little waltz again for you called Moonlight Waltz.
I like my jokes. I can tell. Thank you. Thank you.
polka. Where are you, lady? Where are you? There she is, right there. Do we have a man that can dance a polka here that'll dance with that little lady? Oh, come on, boy. Polka's might be too. Just get on two-step.
Where's Minnesota?
Army now. Remember that one?
Thank you.
guy wants a good one there.
Thank you.
this. We're trying to play all the goodies we remember back from World War II. And you can't go wrong with this one. This is Hoagy Carmichael's Stardust. You like that one? Be glad to let you have it. I mean, he can sing you a song. Tell you about mail chilies. I can tell that guy. Mel Jealous, you know, he's one of the top stars in the country western field. So he was on a... What? His mother, she said, that didn't have anything to do with Mel Jealous. So they were interviewing Mel Jealous in one of these late night talk shows. So they said, Mel, said, you're at the top of the country western field now, but it's bound to have been difficult for you to get started with your speech impediment. You know, Mel stutters. So he said, no. He said, what'd you do before you became, you know, up on up the ladder in the country western? He said, well, I sold Bibles. He said, well, how many did you sell the first month? He said, 200. He said, my God, that's a lot of Bibles to sell for 1 month. How did you manage to sell 200 Bibles? He said, well, I told him I'm a meditator. And I'm telling you about Bible. Do you want to buy one, or you want me to read it to you? Thank you very much. Thank you. she's not legal. This is featured a trombone section, a real fine trombone section. It's called My Fine Blue.
Thank you. except them things are cockeyed on there. Well, it seems like it's be taking pictures somewhere. I wouldn't like that. I don't want to aim down the barrel.